we live in a big world filled with many people, and God loves all the people in the world, no matter where they're from, what they look like, or what language they speak. He wants all of us to get to know Him. The gospel is the good news that Jesus died on the cross and rose again so that He can save us from our sin and bring us closer to God. Say it with me. The gospel is for everyone. Shortly after Jesus went back up to heaven, God the Holy Spirit helped Peter to have boldness and share the gospel with the Jewish people. Peter was focused on this one group of people, the Jews, like himself, who were God's chosen people. And Jesus was a Jew too. Someone who wasn't a Jew is called a Gentile. Most people in the world are Gentiles. One Gentile was an important Roman centurion or commander named Cornelius. The Bible says, even though Cornelius wasn't a Jew, he wanted to serve God and had great respect for God. He prayed a lot and gave generously to the poor. But Cornelius didn't know about Jesus yet, who had come to save people from their sin. One day, while he was praying, an angel of God visited him. The angel said, "Cornelius, send men to Joppa to bring back a man named Simon Peter. He is staying with Simon the Tanner, whose house is by the sea." Cornelius obeyed these instructions and sent two servants and one trusted soldier to travel to the city of Joppa, where Peter was staying. Peter had no idea this was going on, so he was sure in for a big surprise. Meanwhile, Peter went up to the roof of the house where he was staying to pray. It was about noon, and while he was praying, he realized he was starting to get a little hungry. Meanwhile, there were other people who were preparing lunch for Peter and the other disciples. The Bible says God caused Peter to have a vision. A vision is like a dream from God, but when you are awake. So this was something special, and God needed to get Peter's attention to give him a very important message. In this vision, Peter looked up and saw something coming out of heaven. It looked like a big white sheet. The sheet came down closer, closer, and closer until it let down to earth, and Peter could see what was inside. It was all sorts of animals. We might think, wow, all these animals remind me of a zoo. But that's not what Peter thought. He recognized those animals. They were animals the Jews were not supposed to eat. They were called unclean. In the Old Testament, God had given the Jewish people strict rules about animals that were okay to eat and other animals that were not okay to eat. As Peter looked at this unusual sheet of animals, a voice came from heaven and said, "Get up, Peter, kill the animals and eat." Peter was hungry, but these were unclean animals. How can he go against God's instructions from the Old Testament? Peter knew it was God speaking to him, so he said, "Not so, Lord. I have kept your laws and have never eaten anything common or unclean." But God said to Peter, "Do not call anything impure that God has made clean." This strange conversation happened 3 times. Dang, Peter! Jesus always needs to repeat directions 3 times to Peter. After the 3rd time, the sheet was taken back up to heaven. And so what did this vision mean? Peter, a Jew, thought that Gentiles was not part of God's plans for love and salvation. But God wanted Peter to know that God wants all people to hear the gospel and be saved, no matter if you were a Jew or Gentile. God was telling Peter that if he has called something clean, then Peter needed to do the same thing. As Peter continued to think about this very odd vision, Cornelius' servant called out for Peter because they arrived at the gate. They told Peter why they were there, and they brought Peter to Cornelius and all of his family and friends. Cornelius was so excited that he knew that whatever Peter had to tell him was very important and special because God had sent an angel to go get Peter and Cornelius to come to meet. As Peter and Cornelius talked about all that had happened, Peter began to realize God didn't show favorites. He wanted all people, both Jews and Gentiles, to hear the gospel. So Peter shared the gospel, and Cornelius and his family, friends, and others believed in Jesus as the one who could bring them close to God. To show the Jews who came with Peter that the Gentiles were really saved, God did an awesome thing. The Holy Spirit fell upon Cornelius and the others, and they started speaking in tongues, in other languages that had never learned. Peter also told them that everyone should be baptized now that they believed in Jesus. The gospel is for everyone, whether the people back then were Jews or Gentiles, and that's true today too. The gospel is for adults, kids, the rich, the poor. It doesn't matter what race or ethnicity you are, it is for everyone. So go and share the good news of Jesus to everyone you know.